You know, with Rahr Malting using bioenergy to produce their products, it was a no-brainer for us to be able to work with them. You know, being an environmental steward is incredibly important to us. We do what we can as a small brewery to be good stewards. It's nice to see that the malt that we get, there's been a lot of care and attention put into this ingredient. And when we're done with it, the grain goes to local farmers to feed their cattle. To our customers, that's the fun thing about craft beer right now, is they really care about what goes into their beer, the process, the people behind it, and being able to tell the story of what Rahr does for one of our base ingredients is kind of a fun story to share with everybody, and something that our customers are very interested in.
It's good to know that what you're drinking is not only good to taste, but also helping the environment around you as well.
Bioenergy works into what Rahr does through our company, Koda Energy, which produces all the electricity and heat for our malting facility here in Shakopee, Minnesota. Bioenergy is important to Rahr because we feel we need to be good stewards of the environment and natural resources. So having a renewable energy source that we can use to power our malting facility and other aspects of our company here in Shakopee is paramount to us. Rahr sources its barley directly with farmers. The waste material at the time that it's cleaned through the barley cleaning process goes to Koda. Be reused at Koda Energy. The waste material through the malting process also gets used at Koda Energy. Ultimately, that malt is bagged out or sold in bulk to our customers around North America and the world.
Koda Energy is a partnership between the Shakopee Mdewakanton Sioux Community and Rahr Corporation. Most of the fuels that Koda uses formerly entered the waste stream. Would be disposed of in fields and forest. We're taking products that were not a use to society and converting them into useful energy sources that everybody needs.
Bioenergy was an opportunity that we were able to take advantage of in a discussion with Rahr Malting. It was a brainstorm of our former chairman and at the time some of the members of Rahr Malting. The SMSC has always looked to protect Mother Earth, to be a steward of the earth. We have engaged in solar panels and wind energy, geothermal, heating, green projects, green energy to combat the effects of environmental distress on the planet. We believe in global warming, and we also understand that we've always given thanks to all of the benefits of Mother Earth, the trees, the water. It's our job to live within those means, protect those means as best we can, and we reflect that in a lot of our projects.
In Minneapolis and St. Paul, we're really blessed that we have two bioenergy producers that are able to use materials that are taken from insect and disease-killed materials and other storm-damaged materials. Koda Energy is one of those producers, and they create valuable steam and electricity for their customers, and also District Energy St. Paul. District Energy St. Paul is the largest hot water district energy system in North America, and they're using biomass to both heat and cool over 200 buildings in downtown St. Paul. These are hospitals, government buildings, commercial buildings, apartments, just a really important use for biomass that's being removed from urban settings. Emerald ash borer was identified in Minnesota in 2009 in the southeast part of the state, and it's expanded to over 15 counties. There's millions of trees that are affected by emerald ash borer currently, but the greater potential is that Minnesota has over a billion ash trees, and that impact from emerald ash borer is going to be dramatic in the next decade. When emerald ash borer is identified in ash trees, the trees start to die. They die from the top down, and so decisions have to be made to remove those trees. Oftentimes they're on city boulevards, they're on city streets, but they're also in city parks, and those are situations where we have safety considerations that need to be taken into effect. Wood that's used for bioenergy helps support the economy in the state of Minnesota and across the country. It creates jobs for loggers, for truckers, it creates valuable products. We're able to use this material instead of just letting it go to waste or open burning or landfilling. It helps improve forests, it helps create competitive forest products companies in the state. It's a huge economic driver, and I think we need to be conscious of that as many ways as we can. Bioenergy creates rural jobs. Bioenergy creates urban jobs. These are all important jobs that help create healthier industries, that help support healthier forests.
Cheers to bioenergy.